Welcome back to Grandia HD Remaster. We saw a puffy. I mean, Sue's around somewhere. Well, I see Puffy. Yeah, that's definitely Sue. Do it so you don't get caught. Sure. I'm pretty sure you, earlier there was a guy in the harbor that if you talk to them, they mentioned that stowaways get thrown over the side in a barrel. What is Sue in? Especially not the little girl. Yeah, superstitions are a powerful, powerful thing. I mean, if you go back in history and look at people's beliefs and things that they did because they thought of, you know, that X plus Y equals Z, or, you know, if we do this, this happens, or any, you know, things that have been proven completely and utterly wrong. And it seems silly to us, but then again, we might be doing things that, you know, future generations looks back and go, why the hell did they do that? I mean, I'm sure that we can think of a few if we really tried, but let's not. Yeah, that's it. If you missed it earlier, there it is again. I mean, she's still a little girl. Can't we do something about this? Your crane will be fine. It's inanimate. You're absolutely hopeless. Oh. Yeah, the captain is a by-the-books man. Like, if, you know, if the superstition of the time dictates that he throws this girl overboard in a barrel, he will. Yeah, the rules of the sea. You gotta remember, seafaring is what it is at this point in this game, in this. Anyway. Again, superstitions, beliefs, etc., so forth and whatnot. Oh! But you're gonna get thrown overboard in a barrel! I suppose not, but we weren't going to admit that. Captain, come on. I know that. But can we get around that, please? Is there some sort of clause in the superstition that we can get around this? Yikes. That's the idea, and why didn't we discuss this beforehand? Why did we not look for the option first, and then go to move to throw her overboard? That's the intention. Sue? Quiet. I'm trying to save your life. Okay. Better than getting thrown overboard. So if we're working, it's fine. We can get away with it if we're working. I'm not even going to tempt fate and give him the answer of, yeah, just throw Sue overboard. She's my best friend and everything. No, we're not going to be doing that. Yeah. Yeah, you remember how bad second class looked? And then we looked at the sailor's quarters? Yeah, we'll be sleeping there from now on. And considering the amount of sailors we've seen and how many beds were in the sailors' quarters, they must be hot bunking. That's gonna be gross. Okay. You want me to shovel coal to the steam engine? I'll do that if you... Not getting my best friend thrown overboard. Probably not too good. It also feels so strange. The bed was stinking. Also, it's very strange to see Justin without his hat. Like, it happens a few times in the game. It's just, it feels a little bit odd. Yep. It's time to work. Hi. Yeah, we've got to work until we get to the New World. Fair enough. Key to quarters received. We can now get into first class. Because we're going to be working. Also, there's a giant Band-Aid on that bed. Huh. Actually, they all have it, don't they? Does Puffy not need a... Oh, wait, I get it. Justin and Sue are sailors. Puffy is using the pass. Gotcha. Imagine that. Our pet is actually the one using the passenger pass. Oh boy. Now that we work here, people's responses are quite a bit different. And we can actually get a few things, but we need to actually go swap the deck too, which I'm not actually really all too excited about. Hey, you know what? It's the whole thing. If your work is something that you love to do, you will never really work a day in your life. Anyway, deck swapping. This gentleman will show us how to swap decks. Yeah, I might as well get over with. Tell me how to do it. It's basically hold this button and let go so you don't get too tired. It's a easier version of... Well, it's a lot easier version than the arm wrestling in the second one. Which... Although... At least those... This getting the good result in this and getting the good result in the arm wrestling in the second game takes a little bit of, you know, finesse, skill, whatever you want to call it. The minigame in the third one... If you know the if you have, like, a basic understanding of a bell curve, you can win it. And you can win enough of it to get to afford anything that you want from it. Like, this one and the one in the second one, this one, I think, it gives you, like, a little bit of money for doing really well. Like, you can do badly and not get anything, or do well and get, like, 20... I think... I'm pretty sure it's 25 gold. The second one, you can get some items. And the third one, there's, like, a giant list you can get, but it takes a really long time to get all the coins needed. The winning coins needed to actually get it. But if you know probability, you have a rapid-fire controller, and you have, you know, you're going to bed soon, you can... Force the button down, come back, and you have all you'll ever need. Like, once you get past a certain point, you actually can't lose anymore. Like, you can't net lose. Which... The thing is about the third one, though, you can keep going back to it. Like, if you actually enjoy it for whatever reason. But again, I see it as, you know, probability. And it's just, I need X amount of this to get everything I need throughout the game. And you can keep going back to it and blah, blah, blah. Actually, there is a, there's another minigame in the second game that gives you, you have to like capture nuts. You need to grab nuts from a pedestal without getting hit on the head. And I forget what the reward was, but it's worth it. Like, to get a certain amount. You've got to do it a few times, but it's all worth it. 2486. I think that's good enough. I think the cutoff's 26 seconds? Or 28? Yay! Maybe? I mean, they're good at getting dirty. Yeah, pocket 25 gold. And you could do this infinitely. Or do you want it? Nah, it's okay. There's a few times that you actually need to do it. But you can just sit there and talk to him and do that minigame over and over again for 25 gold. I just wait till we get in combat again, personally, because 25 gold is not that much. 30 seconds of regular combat lasts that long. Like, from going into the combat to being done with it lasts that long. Yeah, I mean, not dying is nice. Just saying. Isn't it? Hi. I can't really blame him. No. I'm Justin. Lowly porter. Yeah, no. His name is Justin. What? Your son looked like that. Okay. I think ignorance is bliss in this case, Justin. I don't think we actually want to know. These people are strange. Ten people could say, again, it doesn't actually give you a value. Like, Justin has his pass so he can leave, but it didn't say anything about actually paying for the trip. And here we are now. Well, then again, Java's pass might have been a lifetime pass, so he might not have had to pay anything. He doesn't actually give you a figure. If you talk to somebody while you are a... They tell you that your job is to swab the deck and to also take care of any of the needs of the, you know, actual passengers. That's a little... Yeah, that's a bit extreme, miss. Jeez. Good job, Justin. We'll make a sailor out of you yet. And hey, free 25 gold. That's just for going through a dialogue. That no minigame, no nothing, just 25 gold. Sure. Hi. Justin, Blink Wayne? Sure. Yes. What? I'm confused. Oh. I mean, it happens. You know, there's always, you know, this really eligible person, and then, oh, they have a fiancé, and everybody's like, or, yay, I'm happy for them, or in my case, and whatever, that's their life, not mine, I don't really care at all. That's mine. It's just, unless I personally know you, I really don't care too much about your personal life. You know? It's, you know, if someone said, oh, you know, blah, this happened to me, I'd be like, hey, that's great. But, you know, these people that you have absolutely no contact with, like, at least if someone commented, this happened, be like, oh, hey, but that's contact. I'm talking about things happening with people that you have zero contact with. How does it affect your life? I never understood celebrity gossip. Who cares? Unless they do something really bad, and then it proves out to be true. Then it's like, yeah, okay. Or if they do something really good. You know, there's the two sides of that coin. But, you know, details of their personal... I don't care. It really doesn't matter to me whatsoever. Yeah, that's no ribbon. That is a living, breathing creature. And I think it's sentient as well. Sure. Tails. Oh. If you pick heads, you get your money back. But if you pick tails, like I did, you lose your money. So, the first option is the correct one. Weren't you just talking about wanting to be in love and whatnot? Oh! Nobody has mentioned this to me. Otherwise, Justin would be, you know, vibrating in anticipation by now. Again, ask the captain. Ask, you know, someone above my station, basically. Now, the thing is about this, you have to remember that Sue has freckles too, so actually, like, you know, any of this, like, not at all. She's convinced, talking to her earlier, that she has way too many. Like, she's actually really self-conscious about it. That is just plain me. Uh-huh. Okay. Chocolate. Yeah, that conversation gets you a healing item for 40 HP. Again, it's just a conversation. It's like, here's a healing item. I'll take it. 40 is a little bit high, but, you know. Again, I have Rara with Sue's Rara. As long as you keep an eye on her SP gauge and don't let it fall below Rara, you're really in no danger. At this point of the game. It is. It very much is. So that's them. So I've lost some money. I've gained some money. Although I think after all the swabbing of the deck that I actually have to do, and talking to the people, I'll probably break even for what I came on the ship for. Not that that's really that important. Naughty, naughty. This is true. Yeah, Sue just kind of threw him right under the bus there. Yeah, no. Guess who else is a stowaway? Yeah, because that's so much better. Has anybody tested the... whatchamacallit, to see whether or not it leaks? I'll be a stowaway next... I don't think that's a good idea. Actually, Sue, did I empty your inventory? No, I did not. I should actually do a little bit of inventory maintenance. And in that case, I really ought to buy Sue a new ranged weapon. Because I don't think there's actually one coming up in the near future. Yeah, toy bow. Okay, I want to make sure that I didn't sell an extra mace. Well, a mace that I really actually kind of do need. Don't need that. Don't need that, don't need that. I already have that one. Ceramic sword, I don't think I need that either. And really, we want you to be using the baton. Is that the... Hold on a second. Wait a second. Yeah, no, we want you to use the baton. You're only a level behind. Justin needs to use him. Actually, we should switch your weapon, shouldn't we? Oh, boy. That's fine. Anyway, up until Sue and Justin become sailors, you can't actually save on the steamer. Because the guy who, you notice there's been no save point. The guy who saves for you is actually this guy who says, hey, you need to get out of here. Well, you did it yesterday, too. Then again, Justin is kind of 6 years older. Yeah, he is the guy who saves the game for you. So until you become a crew member, you can't save. So, it is what it is. Anyway, next time, more Grandia HD Remastered. Until then.